Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will continue to discuss GUI programming using PyQt and Qt Designer. We will create a simple calculator. This simple calculator can perform simple math operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. We will use the following widgets in this program: QMain window, QPush button, QLine edit, QCombo box, QLabel, QStatus bar, and QMessage box. We will use a GUI development flow I introduced in a previous video to develop this program. Step 1 is to design the interface in Qt Designer. To start Qt Designer, you can type in Designer in the Windows Start menu. For Mac OS, you can try open-a designer in your terminal to launch Qt Designer. In this new form dialog, we always choose main window and click create. Because I have already created the UI, I'll just open it from my folder. In the view menu, check all these items to show these two boxes. This is the widget box. This is the object inspector. This is the property editor. This is the resource browser. This is the action editor. This is the signal slot editor. Next, I will briefly describe what I did when I created this graphic user interface. I clicked the empty space of the main window. In the property editor, set the main window's geometry width to 400, height to 200. Set the window title to calculator. In the object inspector, there was originally a menu bar. I just right-clicked and removed the menu bar so you don't see it here. We don't need it in this program. In the widget box, I searched for line edit. Dragged and dropped this widget to the main window. I repeated this process two more times. So you see three line edits here. I changed their object names to line edit 1, line edit 2, and line edit 3. Change their tooltips to first number, second number, and result respectively. So when we run this program later and hover the mouse on these line edits, we will see these tooltips. I searched for a combo box in the widget box. Dragged and dropped a combo box to the main window. Double-clicked the combo box, added four operators, plus, minus, star, which means times, and slash, which means divided by. Set the tooltip to operator. Then I searched for label in the widget box. Dragged and dropped a label to the main window. Double-clicked the label and changed the text to equal. I searched for push button in the widget box. Dragged and dropped a push button to the main window. Double-clicked it and changed the text to clear. Change the object name to button clear in the property editor. Change the status tip to clear all the boxes. It will show a tip in the status bar if we hover the cursor on top of this button. I repeated this process and added another push button. Change the text to calculate. And change the object name to button calc. Change the status tip to calculate the result. Let me break out this layout first. Then what I did was selecting the top 5 widgets and click this layout horizontally button. Select the bottom 2 buttons and click this Layout Horizontally button. Use Ctrl A to select all the widgets and click this Layout Vertically button. Click an empty area in the main window and click this Layout in a Grid button. After that, I selected the push button clear. In the signal slot editor, I added a signal, double-clicked the sender and selected button clear. Double-clicked the signal and selected clicked. Double-clicked the receiver and selected line edit 1. Double-clicked the slot and selected clear. I added 2 more signals. Changed the receivers to line edit 2 and line edit 3, respectively. What this does is that when we click the clear button, the contents of these 3 line edits will be cleared. You can preview this interface by pressing Ctrl R or clicking the manual form preview. Type in some numbers and click clear. It works. However, the calculate button does nothing. We will write code to process the click of this button later. After we are done, we save the interface as calculator.gui.ui. If you are interested, you can open this UI file and take a look in the Jupyter editor. It's actually an XML document. Step 2 is to convert the UI file to a Python file using the following command in a command prompt or terminal. PyUIC5-x calculator-gui.ui-o calculator-gui.py. After that, we will get this Python file calculator-gui.py. You can open this Python file and see the content. This file translates the UI file to a Python file using PyQt5. The entire window is an instance of this UI main window class. We can find all the widgets we added to the interface in this setUI function. Like the grid layout, the line edits, the combo box, the push buttons, and the status bar. Some of the properties are defined in this retranslate UI function. Don't change anything in this Python file. All changes made in this file will be lost if we use a PyUIC command again to convert the UI file to this Py file. Step 3 is to code in Python. We need to create a new file named calculator.py. I already did that, so I will just open my file. But you need to write this entire file by yourself if you are writing a new program. Note this is different from the calculator GUI.py. In the first line of this file, we need to import everything from calculator GUI. Then we need to define the signals function to deal with the signals passed by the widgets. This line will connect the calculator button's clicked signal to a user-defined calc function. In this calc function, we will do the actual mass calculation. After the user typed in some numbers, we give the text in line edit 1 to A and the text in line editor 2 to B. They will be the first number and the second number. We give the current text in the combo box to operator. It will be one of the plus, minus, times, and divided by operators. Next, we try to calculate the result by assembling these 3 strings in one expression and executing that expression. For example, if A is 2, B is 4, and the operator is a star, the eval function will do the multiplication. Then we show the calculation result 8 in line edit 3. Some errors may occur when the calculator button is clicked. For example, line edit 1 or line edit 2 is empty, or a number is divided by 0. If an error occurs, we use a message box to show a critical error message, like invalid inputs, The user needs to confirm this error by clicking the OK button before he or she tries again. Next, we need to add these two self-defined functions as new attributes in the UI main window class. The calculator.py file can be run as a standalone program. It can also be imported to other programs as a library. If it is run as a standalone program, like what we will do later, we will need to import the sys library. Every PyQt5 program must create a kill application object. If this program is run in the command line, sys.argv allows the user to pass additional parameters. This statement will create a main window instance. This one will create a UI main window instance. Next, we need to add all the widgets to the main window. Connect the signals or events with the appropriate functions or actions. Show the main window on the computer screen. Wait for the termination signal. It will receive a termination signal when the user clicked the Close Window button on the top right or top left corner, depending whether you are running Windows or Mac OS. If a termination signal is captured, exit the program. Step 4 is to execute the program. We do it in Jupyter Notebook using the run magic. Type in some numbers like 8 or 7, change the combo box to minus, then click calculate. The result is 1. Click the clear button, type in 4 and 0, choose divided by in the combo box. Click calculate. We'll see an error message. Invalid inputs. Change the second number to 8 and click calculate. The result is 0.5. Click the close window button. The program will end. Okay, that was how to use PyQt and Qt Designer to create a simple calculator. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.